Hey YouTube, how's it going, guys? This is going to be a part two video of talking about my dosing pumps I got. Holidays are over. Hope everybody got some cool Christmas gifts for their reef tanks, or if you have a freshwater, or if you have a fish-only reef tank. Excuse me, no freshwater in here, right? If you have a fish-only saltwater tank, hope you got something cool for that too. We don't discriminate, you know. Unfortunately, we're getting back to reality and getting back on a 9-to-5 grind, but the good news is, so we're going to talk about some dosing pumps. So in the future, if you guys are looking to get some, I'll give you price points, everything you need to know about this. Alright guys, so first things first, my girlfriend for Christmas got me the BRS Drew's dosing pumps. The BRS makes another one that's their standard one, and then the Drew's dosing pumps are an upgrade. The standard ones they make are about 65. The Drew's are about 80, right at 80 bucks a piece. They seem to be really nice. I'll turn the camera around and let you guys look at everything here in a second. So let's go over the pumps. Okay, so first of all, it comes with 3 zip ties, some hard, clear tubing, about 5 feet, but I'm not exactly 100% sure. It's either 4 or 5 feet. And it also comes with a 100 milliliter dosing cup, about yay big. It's in intervals of 10. And it has marks on it, so 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, so on and so forth. So that cup is important because when you first get your pump, the first thing you want to do is run it for 10 minutes. Alright, so when you hook it up, you know, you'll wait for all the air bubbles to get out. And then as soon as you start getting product into the cup, that's when you want to start your time. So BRS tells you to run it for 10 minutes. And after 10 minutes, see how much fluid is in the cup. So they say that their pumps give about 1.5 to 1.6 milliliters per minute, and I'd say that's pretty accurate. That's what happened with mine. So you'll, for example, you'll run it for 10 minutes. If you get 15 milliliters of fluid, you would divide 100 into 15, and you would get 1.5 milliliters per minute. That's how you get your math. So same thing, if you got 16 milliliters, you do 16 divided by 100, and then you'd get 1.6 milliliters, for example. It may vary slightly, so that's why I tell you to do that. Your left-hand side of the tube is your input, your right hand side is your output. Remember that, left hand side input, right hand side output. There's a couple of things to remember when you're doing this. First of all, I called BRS and asked them if there's anything I need to know. So don't use soft, clear, flexible tubing. Use the hard, flexible tubing that they supply you. They tell you not to use the soft. I bought this, it's on BRS, it's in a little container about this big. It's called Drew's Lubricant or something like that. If you go on their website and click on dosing pumps and then click on related products, you'll see it. It's almost like a Vaseline, but you use that on the tips of the dosing pump hoses, because when you go to plug up the tubing, it makes it much more easier to push in. And when you push in the tubing, you want to make sure it's all the way seated as best you can, and you'll put zip ties at the end of the tubing where it connects to the pump tubes, and I'll show you that. And you want to make sure it's secure because you don't want any vacuum. So those are some little tidbits. So with that being said, I'll go ahead and kind of show you guys the pumps, how I got set up, and we'll go from there. You know, I'll kind of let you guys get an idea of what it all looks like. So, okay, so these are the pumps I've got. All right, so you can see I've got them all marked. I got the calcium, magnesium, alkalinity. And so, see, this would be your output line. This is your input line. So left input, right output. You can see I have the zip ties on there. And you can see that you want to put the lube on the... So down here, there's a nipple. You want to put the lube on the nipple, slide it up. I use just like a rag to help slide it on there. And then I also got these 1 gallon Space Saver jugs from BRS. And you can see they're coordinated. So mags on the left, alkalinity and calcium. And mags left, alkalinity and calcium. So with that being said, also marked like a add line right there. So when it's low, and I also marked, you can see it right here, little black lines. So those black lines are, what I did was I put the tubes down all the way to the bottom of these containers, and once they hit the bottom, I marked them with a black line. So what that does is that it ensures me that I know that I'm not going to be sucking out air, that it's going to always be at the bottom. So I marked the lines. And I also did that because me being in the military when I'm gone, hopefully my girlfriend will watch the tank. And this is all supposed to be to help make her life easier. Because when you're not doing this every day, you're not always familiar with stuff. So when she puts in the additive, like something like this, when she puts in the ESV magnesium, then she'll know when, A, she'll know when it's low. And then B, she'll be able to know where to put the tubes at. And so I try to pull out all stops for her. So right now, as you can see, I'm still testing everything to make sure it works. So I've got it hooked up. Right now I have two timers. I have one in the mail. But I've got two timers. These are also bought from BRS. They're $20 a piece. They actually didn't get very good reviews on BRS. And there's another one made by Hamilton that I probably should have bought, but I kind of asked for the wrong ones for Christmas because these were a Christmas gift and I really wasn't paying attention. So these are timers. Most of the timers that run the week and the day and they have a lot of different settings are kind of bulky. And I ran to the problem to where I had to get a 7-outlet power strip because if you get 6, it's just not big enough to hold all timers. It's one too short. So if you run into that same problem, I used that. Also, I used the 3M command strips to hold these up. I want to switch to like an industrial Velcro so I can just pop out the Velcro. But I had some of these laying around the house, and I thought that it would just be easier to do that than go and buy the Velcro because it's a little bit pricey if you get it from the hardware store. It's really nice, though. So you kind of get the idea there. And as far as the rest of it, you can see how I have the dosing pumps. Hooked up into this little dosing pump holder. It's actually specifically made for dosing pump lines and clips onto your sump area and you can adjust as follows. So I want to talk about how the pumps actually work. So I'll give you an example before you have to go buy these. So the way it works is that if your pump is pumping 1.5 milliliters per minute. Write that down, keep that in mind. So if your alkaline is 8 dKH, and let's say per day it drops a half a dKH, it drops down to 7.5, so from 8 to 7.5 in a day. And let's say that you dose this alkalinity, and you know the 10 milliliters of alkalinity brings up your DKH 0.5, which would bring it back up to 8.0. So what you would do is, since you know you have 1.5 milliliters on your dosing pump, you would just times that the amount of minutes, So it's 1.5 per minute. So you would times that by 7. So 1.5 times 7 minutes equals 10.5 milliliters. So you know you'd have to run your timers for at least 7 minutes. And what I recommend you do is break up your time in segments. So those particular timers, they can do up to 8 different time segments a day. So what I did was, if you have 10.5, you could break it up in like 4 blocks, 2, 4, 6, 8, well, maybe not 4, but you know, you could break it up in different times of the day to where it dispenses a little bit here, a little bit there, a little bit there. And so you're not dispensing 10.5 all at once. I don't think it would cause any real major problems, but I think it's just better if you dispense slowly. It's probably not as much of a shock on your corals. 10.5 is not a whole lot, but some of these reefers, you know, their tank consumes a lot more than that. It's a big deal. So anyways, this is my video on dosing pumps. I hope you enjoyed it. Please comment back if you have any questions. I can't at this moment think of anything else I need to really say about it. Total cost would be to run 3 timers for magnesium alkalinity. And just bear with me here, guys. I got to do math real quick. 8, 16, 24, 24, 60, plus 60. 3. So for the timers and the pumps, and you know, if you have to buy power strips and stuff like that, I would say total to get this whole setup out the door for what I have, it's pumps, 3M strips, everything you're going to need, is right around $330. $300 to $320, yeah. So it's $300 to $320, right around that range. So it's expensive to run dosing pumps. Well, wait a minute, I didn't calculate the 1 gallon Space Saver jugs. I'd say it's closer to $310 to $330. So $310 to $330, roundabout. So you guys have a price point, now you know how much it cost. Something you need to save up for, you certainly can. Anyways, hope you guys have a wonderful night, and please comment. Take care. Bye bye.